the Bridal Show. Right now we're actually at the Thoroughbred Center and we're meeting with Amy Jackson. Amy, could you tell us a little bit about your role here at the Thoroughbred Center?
Yeah, I am the event and tour coordinator.
Okay.
I coordinate most of the events here. I have an assistant that helps me. And then I also coordinate the tours, group tours that come through, 20 or more people, to take on the other part of what we do here, giving tours of the backside about the training of the thoroughbreds, which is our primary focus here.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, you think
the horses.
Yeah, you think Thoroughbred Center and you automatically think horses, but you guys do a lot of weddings here, don't you?
We do. We do around 50% of our business is weddings. And we'll do about a wedding a weekend. And that's about half our business, so you have 100-110 events on average a year.
Yeah, and you guys have several different locations within this huge facility where you have events at. I know in this main ballroom you have receptions, but where are some other places in and around the facility you have events?
Well, this is the lounge, and this is our smaller of the two rooms. It is more formal. I can seat anywhere 150 to 200 people in this room, and then I have a larger room in the back that we call the holding area. Mm-hmm. It's a little more rustic. It's more like a barn. It's really popular right now. And it seats anywhere from 200-300 people. My maximum capacity is 500 seated or 1,000 standing.
Wow. Okay, that's a lot of people.
Yes, it's an 8,800 square foot room. Then we also have an auditorium that we call the pavilion. It's the old sales pavilion. When this facility was built, it was built with the idea of horse sales in mind.
Okay.
With also doing special events, but the primary focus was the sales. And it seats 920 people. It has a big 20 by 60 foot stage. And that's where we do conferences, seminars, large conferences and seminars. We've also done some wedding ceremonies in there.
Okay.
Especially if you're having a larger wedding, like a 300 person wedding, and then you could do the reception in the room behind it, the holding area. We do have a small conference room too that could be really good for board meetings, bridal showers, baby showers, that kind of thing. It can seat 20, 30 people. So those are our four main spaces, and we always keep our minds open to doing other things.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll try anything about once.
Speaking of being open-minded, I'm sure you've seen some interesting things happen here. What are some of the more fun events you've seen?
Well, I've been here since the fall of 2007.
Okay.
So I've seen quite a few events come through. One of the biggest events, I'd say the biggest event that we've done since I've been here is the Buddy Walk for the Down Syndrome Association.
Oh, okay.
And we get to do that again this year. So that's probably the biggest event.
Wow. Okay.
As far as fun events, we have fun events all the time. It's hard to narrow any down.
Yeah.
I'd say, what I like is when I get to do more.
Mm-hmm.
We're a facility that can be very hands-off or we can be very hands-on. Mm-hmm. It's kind of whatever the bride wants. And so when I get to do more, then obviously I'm more personally invested in the event.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
if I get to coordinate the food and coordinate the bar and the centerpieces and all the rentals and everything that goes into it, those are fun for me.
Will you let people bring in a variety of food vendors? I mean, are there particular people you decide to work with, or do you just let people customize it, basically?
We work with South Bend Events a lot.
Okay.
And they are what we call our preferred caterer.
Okay.
But we have an open catering policy. So if you wanted to use an outside caterer, somebody in your family caters, or if it's not a wedding and you wanted to do just a family reunion and it's potluck style, then we just charge $100 catering deposit and you can use whoever you want.
Okay.
Yeah, we're really a flexible facility.
Well, what's the process like when a bride first contacts you and says she wants to see the facility and meet with you? What are some of the first things that you guys like to do?
Well, it's usually a phone call or an email that I get. Most of the time, they've heard about us from somewhere, read about us online. They've already seen pictures. Sometimes they already know which room they're more interested in than the other. I always encourage somebody to come and look at the facility. Very rarely do I ever book a wedding without the bride actually seeing the site first.
Definitely.
So we make an appointment for her to come out, or him, Sometimes it's the bride and groom. Sometimes it's an entourage of people.
Okay.
And they come out and I show them around. Too. It takes about 30 minutes. Mm-hmm. I answer whatever questions they can come up with. And from there, I just kind of gauge how they feel about it. Sometimes they're ready to sign on the dotted line before they even leave. Mm-hmm. So we just kind of, I follow their lead in that regard. I don't ever want to pressure anybody and make them feel
definitely
that, you know, they have to choose right now what they want to do. I'm laid back in that regard.
Very nice.
Yeah. Do you ever have any brides and grooms wanting to have an equine theme to their wedding or reception? You're surrounded by some of the best racehorses in the bluegrass around here.
Yeah.
Any interesting stories or insights into that?
Not necessarily in an equine theme. We do derby themes from time to time, or Kentucky weddings, where you've got a lot of Kentucky foods.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a lot of Kentucky wines and bourbons, and they'll bring in whiskey barrels or hay bales, or just kind of keeping it Kentucky. Their favors might be horseshoes.
Oh wow!
With a little story about what horseshoes, like why they're lucky.
Yeah,
that
definitely.
Kind of thing. One thing that we did that was really interesting, and this actually wasn't a wedding, but it was a fundraiser. They made this replica of the Kentucky Derby blanket of roses, but in their colors for their event. And we actually got a horse from the backside, brought him out onto the pavilion stage, and let people take pictures with her.
That's awesome. I bet those pictures were gorgeous.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah.
That was a really fun time.
Very nice.
Yeah.
So about how many people work on staff here?
We are very small. I am the...
Small but efficient, right?
Small but efficient. I'm the event coordinator, and I have an assistant. And then we have, that's two. She's part-time, though. So I think we have six full-time. And mm-hmm. then we have tour guides that work with us during the tour season, which is, since I man both events, they kind of
overlap a little bit.
Yeah. Then we have our receptionist and our general manager, our stall manager. Our administrative assistant. We have a financial coordinator who does our accounting for us, and our head of maintenance. And then we do have a whole maintenance crew mm-hmm. that is responsible for keeping the grounds in the building. Mm-hmm.
It looks lovely. Great. I mean, it's well taken care of, obviously, and it looks really nice.
We appreciate you spending time with us today, and we encourage everybody out there to definitely check out the Thoroughbred Center for your next reception.
Thank you, Amy.
Thank you, guys.